Today I'm going to be going over my top features and shortcuts in Ableton. These features are for beginners or for people just starting in Ableton. I use these features all the time in my workflow. So let's dive in. So the first shortcut, it involves clips. Clips represent recorded audio and MIDI signals. And what I love about clips is that you could do different sequences in each of these clips and you could play around with your arrangement. Another thing about clips is that if you like your melody, but you wanted to try it with another instrument, it's really easy to do. All you have to do is you can just go to what you just played out. And now all we have to do is just hold Option and drag this into another instrument. And now I can just go through other instruments and see if anything else sounds good. Now, if you don't like a clip, it's really simple to get rid of. All you got to do is just hit delete. If you ever run out of clips, it's always easy to add more clips too. You can just hold Command and do I, and that's going to add more. Another way is you can just right click and you can insert a scene. So if you want to see more than one instrument in your piano roll, all you have to do is just go to the instrument that you'd like to see with it, and then you can hold Command and you can just click. And that'll show you the notes from your other instrument. You can actually add more than that if you want to as well. Also, to go back and forth between the arrangement and session view, all you have to do is hit Tab. And you can also click this up here. If you want to see the plugins in the piano roll, you can click down here, or you can also do Shift Tab. And to go over some copy paste, Command A will just copy your notes and not your full loop. If you want to duplicate your entire loop, make sure that your loop is selected here with the orange loop tool. Once you have the desired length, then to select your loop, use Command Shift L. And once you've done that, you can duplicate your loop. So you can just use Command D. Command L turns off and on your loop. You can do Command Shift U. That'll go ahead and bring up the menu to go ahead and choose your grid pattern that you want to quantize it to, and then the amount that you want to quantize it to. And then you can just do Command U, and that's going to quantize your track. To turn off and on the draw tool, it's just B. So you can draw in your notes this way. This also works with automation as well. Another handy feature, and this works for clips and it works for notes as well. If you ever want to mute something, really easy way to do it is just highlight the note or the clip that you want to mute and you just press zero. Something else that isn't always straightforward as well is if you want to solo more than one track, you just hold Command and then you can solo the individual tracks that you want to go ahead and solo. Now to copy paste the clip, all you got to do is hold Option and then just drag it into the clip that you want to copy it into. Now this up here is going to activate all the tracks that are going to be in your arrangement view. Now, an easy way to drag a clip from session view into your arrangement view is to just click on the clip and then you go ahead and hit Tab, and then you can go ahead and drag that where you need to. Now, if you want to add a locator, all you have to do is you can just right click and hit Add Locator. You can also go over here to this set. And set will also add locators as well. And then you can move between the locators right here. Now to turn on automation, you can either click right here or you can hit A. To loop a section in arrangement view, you can highlight your selection and then you can hit Command L. This helps also because then you can just render whatever portion you want to really easily. Or if you just want to listen to a certain section, you can just do Command L and now you can just listen to that section. If you ever want to turn down the preview of your samples or the metronome, you can come down here and this is going to turn it down or up. And this is your preview cue volume. Now, if you want to change your grid patterns, a shortcut for that is you hold Command and you can do 1 to go up. You can do 2 and go down. 3 does triplets. And you can turn the grid off by doing Command 4. And this grid shortcut also works in arrangement view. So if you wanted to turn off the grid, you can do Command 4 as well. Option Command E will expand your piano roll. Now, if you ever want to warp a sample to do either halftime or double time, all you have to do is hold shift right here, and then you can go ahead and warp your sample. So those are my top features and shortcuts in Ableton. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Peace out.